Today we are reading Glimpses into the Beyond, a manuscript written by Fu Xiuwen during her spare time discussing the art of divination, calculations, and all kinds of antidotes relating to divination. Inquiry into the Gods, an introduction. The diviner's art lies in surveying the past to predict the future. Humans walk the paths, while stars cross the sky. Observing these situations can produce future predictions. All of this is based on the diviner's ascertainment of the present situation, or the past, because the present is constantly becoming the past. However, the founder of the Divination Commission system, Master Xiuwen Yao, said, "Only the universe and the eons cannot be foretold." In her opinion, the universe and the eons it births are utterly beyond prediction. The reasoning is simple. Nobody can observe the universe from all angles at once and predict the future. Omniscience is unattainable. Putting aside the universe, those known as eons are also extremely powerful due to their various complex elements. This future is like that of the universe itself, beyond the ability of our calculations. From the perspective of a celestial body, an eon is by no means dead, but rather a living creature with a transcendent mind. But viewed from the perspective of a living creature, the eon fills the skies like celestial bodies themselves. They are incomparably huge, move according to their own path, and rarely communicate with mortals like us. Based on observational records, Master Xiuwen Yao has sorted all known eons into three categories. Arbiters, determining mortal births and deaths, which are highly connected to the rise and fall of civilizations. The sacrosancts, difficult to predict as good or evil, often unable to even know where they are headed for. The authors of calamity, the main culprit behind all disasters, avoid or be annihilated. The eons currently known to us are Lin, the Rainbow Arbiter, Quilpoth, the Firmament Arbiter, Nous, the Wisdom Walker, Akavili, the Cloud Strider, Aha, the Joy Seeker, Idrilla, the Wonder Gazer, Yao Shi, the Plague's Author, Nanook, the Rune Author, Tezirunth, the Swarm Author. Inquiry into the Gods, the Arbiters. Rainbow Arbiter, the Lord of the Path of the Hunt. We know them as Lin, God of the Skybow. They rarely appear before mortals, and the only portents of their presence are visages of the Lux Arrow tearing across the sky. Rainbow tirelessly hunts the undead abominations created by the Yaoshi, the Abundance. Rainbow Arbiter first appeared around the year 3400 Star Calendar, with their sky-shattering Lux Arrow severing Abundance's Abrosial Arbor. Since then, the Xianzhou natives had risen out of chaos, madness, and decline. This also marked the formation of the Alliance. To this day, one of the chief duties of the Divination Commission is to monitor the decrees of the Rainbow's Arrow and interpret its meaning. Firmament Arbiter, Lord of the Path of Preservation, also known as the Amber Lord, and as Quilpoth, God of the Skywall by the Interastral Peace Corporation. Observational records suggest that the Amber Lord strives to isolate contact between planets. The celestial-sized structures they've built, the subspace crystalline barrier, separates and protects all worlds. Based on records from around year 1000 SC, the nine initial Xianzhou ships first set sail on their arduous journey and witnessed the almighty barrier separating the world from the endless void, the Akinda Skywall. But contrary to the act of separation, the main faction devoted to the Amber Lord, the IPC, has facilitated civilized trade and contact between the stars with their fleet, the largest in the entire universe. Like a silent giant, Quilpoth has allowed them to trade and immigrate so much so that the Emanator of Preservation has appeared at the IPC. Despite their actions running counter to the Aeon's wishes, no remonstration or censure has been seen forthcoming. Who'd have forethought, indeed? Inquiry into the Gods, the Sacrosancts. Wisdom Walker, Lord of the Path of Erudition, known as Nous, the God of Intellect by the Genius Society and the Intelligentsia Guild. None can comprehend Nous's intentions, location, or normal state. People merely spread word of a magnificent machine intelligence that has been upgraded into an Aeon, calculating the essence of the universe and its ultimate solution. Before the answer is disclosed, they will summon all the greatest minds in the universe together to examine and discuss results. I myself have had the honor to witness the divine corpus of Nous, and thus may be able to add a few more comments here. Contrary to standard thinking, Nous is not a god that provides solutions. On the contrary, all they offer is an infinite number of questions. Many people spend their whole lives walking through a fog of ignorance, eager for knowledge but unable to find a proper approach. they are hindered by such things as precedence and knowledge. Visiting Nous is enough to open the eyes of even the most ignorant people to see the problem, but the answer may only be found by oneself. The Dauntless Scholars of the Divination Commission can follow the example of great scholars from the Intelligentsia Guild by stepping on the road to opening one's eyes. If fate is predestined, the Council of Nous must be sought. Cloud Strider, Lord of the Path of Trailblaze, known by the Nameless as Akavili, God of Roaming. Only several unverifiable legends about the Cloud Strider remain. For the Xianzhou people, the word legend connotes images of an unfathomably ancient time. Since the first epoch of the Amber Era, Akavili has sped through the wild worlds of the cosmos. It is precisely because of the Nameless and their existence that those isolated worlds scattered throughout the dark cosmos are able to know each other. The Cloud Strider's most important miracles have been creating the Chromatic Echelon and Star Rail. Legend has it that the Chromatic Echelon is a key component of laying the Star Rail network, and the Star Rail itself could connect distant galaxies by means of a mysterious mechanism. Be it the Interastral Peace Corporation or the Xianzhou, the safe routes we all rely upon today all follow remnants of these star tracks. If Akavili had never fallen, it's hard to imagine what contact between the planets would be like today. Based on the Xianzhou Yutui's latest intel, the Cloud Strider's Chromatic Echelon has reappeared after thousands of years. Abominations run rampant, and the Legion ravages the people. In these troubled times, what can the Nameless bring to the cosmos? I can scarcely imagine. Joy Seeker, Lord of the Path of Elation, known by the masked fools and mourning actors as Aha, God of Tricksters. If we lay out a spectrum of mortal to Aeon, based on an Aeon's modus operandi, then Aha is an Aeon who is closer to the mortal end of things. They play with the love, hate, joy, and sorrow of intelligent creatures to subvert and shift fate. As their followers put it, they enjoy this and even manifest in human form sometimes to catalyze the change. It would be wrong to assume that the Joy Seeker is a jester among the Aeons. Yes, they can't really perform earth-shattering miracles like the Rainbow Arbiter or the Firmament Arbiter. However, by using their invisible hand, they can imperceptibly influence the movements of all living things. This demonstrates an extraordinary and delicate manipulation of reality. For example, during Emperor Rubert's campaign, Aha's believers kicked off another riot after the Philosopher Union was reduced to the domain of inorganic life, infecting the Conqueror's computer system with another troll virus called the Philosopher's Poison, and overthrowing the local robot army. Similar miracles abound, and tiny ripples eventually became a tsunami that can shake the whole world. This is Aha's style. Wonder Gazer, Lord of the Path of Beauty, known as Idrilla, God of Beauty by the Knights of Beauty, and the Mirror Holders, known on some worlds as Andoray. So far, the Knights of Beauty have been disbanded, leaving the Mirror Holders to wander the stars searching for their holy relics. All of this serves as proof that they have fallen. But my documents exchange with the Intelligentsia Guild mention, if the relics of the Wonder Gazer can be found intact, their beautiful countenance will be able to reappear. According to ancient myth, Idrilla once attributed the beauty of all the star zones to themselves, showing heroes, villains, and mortals the meaning of aesthetics and contained within the cosmic landscape and driving them to complete astonishing but often devastating achievements for Idrilla's own pleasure. This myth may reveal the true meaning behind the Path of Beauty, the integration of consciousness, insight, and values. Inquiry into the Gods, Authors of Calamity. Plague's Author, ruler of the Path of Abundance, our greatest nemesis, the denizens of Abundance and the Xianzhou Alliance know them as Yao Shi, the God of Life. In short, you diviners must have read about the myth of them manifesting aboard the Lofu to leave behind the Ambrosial Arbor. Perhaps you've heard about that while studying in the Lyceum, serving in the Cloud Knights, or reading novels. There is no need for this book to devote pages to it. It is worth reiterating to everyone once more that any action involving predicting the Plague's Author's fate are viewed as an unforgivable felony. I know that diviners suffer from hubris during their first 100 years of practice, sinking into a form of madness gained from possessing extraordinary knowledge. They would believe that they can control destiny, and that they literally have the power to decipher the entire world. They would be deluded to the point of ignoring the ban on running divinations on eons and try learning the secrets of ancient works. A blind eye can be turned if a diviner tries to predict the fate of other eons. However, the Ten Lords Commission has issued a ban on predicting Yao Shi's fate, listing it as a crime equal to the 10 unpardonable sins, and promising strict punishment. That is, if you are even still alive after your transgression. The plague's author is the reason the Shinjo natives became a long-life species. There is, therefore, some sort of undefinable and remote connection between us and Yaoshi. This kind of connection cannot yet be explained by physics, and may be one of the causes of Mara. Moreover, anyone trying to peer at Yaoshi by means of divination will suffer a similar backlash. Every instance of such actions so far has led to tragic results. These records are filed away under violations in the Divination Commission's repository. Diviners, please study them carefully. Ruin Author, ruler of the Path of Destruction, known as Nanook, God of Destruction by the Antimatter Legion and Annihilation Gang. Despite being the most recently ascended Aeon, Nanook and their minions may already be considered the greatest menace in all the cosmos. In contrast to how the healing forces of the Plague Author brought about mutation and destructive results, the Ruin Author causes chaos in a far more direct way. Them and their emanators lead the Antimatter Legion on their march to invade all civilized worlds, turning these planets to ashes. Despite following the Rainbow Arbiter's edict to hunt down abundance and out-of-control abominations, the Alliance has also fought tens of thousands of skirmishes against the Legion. Our scouts' reports begin to often lack news from planets that have established civil relations with the Shenzhou. All of this is drastically worrying. Perhaps in the near future, the abominations won't be the only nemesis that Shenzhou has to face. Swarm Author, ruler of the Path of Propagation, known by the IPC and other victimized planets as Taseronth, God of Proliferation, known on some worlds as the Imperator Insectorum. Despite the Imperator Insectorum's early demise, they've cast a shadow of terror on the universe no less than that of Emperor Ruberts. The Alchemy Commission has collected from many planets unique biocontaminant samples, which are the Swarm's evolved genes known as their propagation vector. The armed archaeologists from the Intelligentsia Guild have provided even more evidence that stars seeded by the Swarm Author have irreparably become literal hellscapes, and their only end lies in obliteration by Star Destroyer arsenals to prevent further danger. According to the scholar, such horrors have not completely disappeared. The Imperator Insectorum's descendants remain, and their own body could return at any moment. This scholar once showed me his collection, a dull yellow piece of amber with moving flecks and a buzzing tremor. I was absolutely gobstopped to hear him say that it is part of the Imperator Insectorum's prison cell. The amnesia implanted in my forehead could not see the future of this item, which only serves to corroborate the scholar's claims. All I can do is pray in silence to the Rainbow Arbiter that such a day will not come soon.